I haven't thought about Gran Turismo for years, and this was just revisiting the past. I used to play it with my teenage boys. A lot of good memories came back.
Gran Turismo means everything to my generation. The first Gran Turismo came out during my childhood. Looking back, it was probably one of the most pivotal moments in cementing my journey to becoming a car designer.
We had several designers that were doodling tons of little VGT sketches, and you'd go by their desks and ask them, that's not one of the programs, what is that? Oh, that's a Vision GT. And when you realize that there's that kind of passion happening unofficially on a project, we thought it's time to make this an official kickoff.
We really wanted to capture an emotion out of the first read. The car needs to sit on the ground and feel like it's moving at high speeds.
As soon as the leading design is identified, globally we assist this design by pushing it digitally around the globe. Our ideas get floated through Korea, they push them back to Europe, Europe pushes them back to us, and there's always the input from our leadership.
We start off through our whole digitalization process. We have a lot of the designers generating their ideas, translating them from 2D into 3D, and then from there we go through a fairly extensive process of mill checking the model in full size to make sure that the proportions, the archetype is correct.
The entire silhouette of the vehicle was designed with aerodynamics in mind. Upon refinement, working with the engineers, they really challenged every radius, every section on the vehicle, so that it performs at its highest.
Once we have established the right type of proportion, we'll get a lot of the different groups involved in the process as well to really come through there and help us fine-tune the design through its development process.
We really wanted to resolve all the challenges of airflow with the silhouette of the vehicle. Starting from the front, there's a large cutaway so that lowers the frontal mass. And then as it sweeps over the cabin, the rear deck lid has a spoiler that seals off that airflow. The vehicle really is engineered to cut through the air and be very streamlined.
When we first started thinking about the design of the VGT interior, we thought about the beauty of white space and how to apply it to a race interior.
At the beginning of this project, we were met with many challenges. One of them being the cabin size. We had to determine what was best for aerodynamics and what was best for occupant.
The examples of beauty of white space in this interior comes in several forms. The interior begins as a lightweight monocoque, which is sculpted around the driver. Carefully considering the negative space to create a cocoon, we wanted to give our drivers an edge. So we designed an integrated panoramic display that stitches together the side and rear view cameras to create ultimate track awareness. We've also consolidated all of the buttons into a few different touch points to enable faster operation.
The Genesis X Gran Berlinetta Vision Gran Turismo concept, we wanted to instill the Genesis DNA that we have in our brand and our design, and it starts with the front end. So we took the inspiration for our front end came from the Genesis wing badge with the crest shape, and our two-line signature that you'll find on all of our cars is exactly what we put into this car as well.
As we created the Genesis X Gran Berlinetta Vision Gran Turismo concept, we saw the opportunity to link the racing enthusiast from the Gran Turismo games to our product, which is a fantastic carrier for our message.
I feel like the mission behind this vehicle is a lot larger than the car itself. It's really to capture the future audiences and educate them on how to love cars again. The spirit and soul of a car should be seen at first glance, and the emotion should be driven by desire. This is what we pass down to the next generation.
We always look at our concept cars as a projection or window into the future to better understand what could be on the horizon. So I think that's part of why we do the vision vehicles is to really understand where the ceiling is for the brand.